Hey guys, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to stay updated when I make a new upload. Please do follow me on Instagram for different types of posting cars.
Guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have this the BMW 3 Series GT, the 3 GT. So let's quickly get in the boot. The boot is 5 ton liters and the spare wheel eats up the place. You have a space here. So the boot is large enough, 5 ton liters, but the usable thing, the you have a spare wheel, so it eats up all the place. And the loading lip is quite low, but if you take out the spare wheel, it's a big usable boot. You have the partial shift there. You get a one touch function for the boot. You get rear LED tail light, rear parking sensors, reverse parking camera, and you get a functional rear exhaust pipe. So the car is, I think it's long enough, like I think it's around 4.8 meters long, and the tire size is 225/50R 18 inches alloy wheels, 5 lug nuts. But the alloy wheel design is kind of plain, it could have been better, I would say. Body color door handles, you get frameless doors on this car, so like you can put it down, it will be like a sports car. You get silver lining of door handles, power window switch, door pockets of decent size, 1 liter bottle won't fit here. BMW badging here, the scuff plate. Now getting in will be a problem for me because I'm 6 feet tall. Legroom and knee room is massive, I would say. Magazine holder, scooped out seat back. Underside support is also good. And headroom is not much because it has a sloping roofline. Get rear AC vents with a cigarette lighter. Large transmission tunnel, so 3 people won't be comfortable, but the cabin is wide enough. Get a rear armrest. It's not working. With the twin cup holders, it has some space here. It has 3 adjustable headrests. Now you get a handle with a hook here, with large panoramic sunroof. You get lights here as well. Yeah, and you sit kind of low, so the visibility around is not that much. Let me take you to the driver's seat. You get a speaker here. Body colored working fit turn indicators. The front look of the car. Large kidney grills. This is the luxury line variant, the 320 GT. Now you can see the frameless doors. Yeah, so it looks kind of cool and kind of you can like adjust the rear spoiler. This is the switch for the power windows and for the auto ORVMs. This is the silver lining of door handle. Door pockets are large enough and you can fit a 1 liter bottle easily. You get electric adjust for the driver's seat with memory function. Then you get a driver armrest here. It doesn't open. It gets a manual handbrake here, so it opens. Some space here with USB. Good finish here. This is the iDrive controller. 8-speed automatic gearbox. This is the Eco Pro and Sport mode. Traction control. Parking sensors. Twin cup holder with a cigarette lighter. Wireless charging pad. And this is the dual zone automatic climate control. 8 preset buttons. Now let me switch on the engine right away. And this is the key. You get unlock, lock, and you can open the boot directly from the key. So this is the auto start-stop system with the engine start-stop button. It also has an automatic climate control which works brilliantly well. Common flat speed control. Now this is for the cruise control, this is the volume control. You get the control for the headlight and the intensity of the instrument cluster. Now you get a mirror with a light, and here you get a mirror with a light. It gets 6 airbags, ABS with EBD, ESP, traction control, and here you get a large panoramic sunroof. So it brings in a lot of airy feeling. So for long drives, you won't feel claustrophobic. Now Let me show you the controller. It kind of looks old school now, plain and basic, not that great, but it's good and slick to use. Vehicle settings, iDrive settings, driver profiles, vehicle status, technology in action, driving information, owner's handbook. So we go to vehicle settings, lights, key, speed warning, drive mode. You can like set it Eco Pro or Sport. Then you have iDrive settings, vehicle status, tire pressure. It has tire pressure monitoring system as well. Engine oil level, tire pressure monitor, check control, service requirements. You can check the mobile devices, language, touchpad, displays, date and time units, sound, notifications, pop-up, software update, getting started, data privacy, and then you have technology in action, driving information, trip computer, onboard computer, owner's handbook. So a lot of control. This is the instrument cluster, which is kind of plain and basic like the old school. This is the fuel meter, this is the speedometer, this is the tachometer, and this is the engine temperature meter. And here is the glove box. The glove box is large enough with a light here. Let me show you an audio right away. This is the controller with controls, computer, media, menu, map and navigation. Let me get into menu. You get navigation, media, radio. Now the audio quality is phenomenal, but in Chennai we get this Tamil radio station, so I don't have that much, I would say, the variety of songs. Now, let me show you the engine bay. Getting in and out is a problem for me. This is the 2-liter diesel engine, 4-cylinder, which produces 190 horsepower and 400 newton meters of torque. The claim time of 0 to 100 of this car is around 7.5 seconds and an electronic limited top speed of 250 kilometers per hour. The fuel tank capacity of this car is around 60 liters and the mileage will be around 20.34 kilometers per liter. So in the real world, you can expect in the city around 12 kilometers per liter and the highway around 16 kilometers per liter, not more than that. It gets a shark fin antenna. So overall, my verdict on this car is about to get discontinued. This is the old one. Now they have the 330i, the M Sport Shadow version. So that is a 2-liter petrol only. So that produces around 250 or 255 horsepower and same torque, the 400 newton meters of torque. It has some black alloy wheels and not much difference. Like, it has a special blue color. This is the dark blue, it has a light blue. So my verdict on this car is good. But the features are lacking. Like, you pay and like 5 to 10 lakh extra for the long version like this one. So if you are getting it for good bargain, so it's worth it, or else it's definitely not worth the price around 60 lakhs for those times. So thank you so much. Please do like, comment and subscribe. If you are having any queries, you can ask me on Instagram or comment on YouTube.